Hello, Airbus cockpit coach here. You're joining me on the flight deck of the Fenix model of the Airbus 320 inside Microsoft Flight Simulator. And today we're going to have a look at the Traffic Collision Avoidance System, otherwise known as TCAS. So what is TCAS? Quite simply, it's an onboard system and it's designed to prevent mid-air collisions. The system monitors the airspace around an aircraft for other aircraft equipped with transponders that may pose a collision threat. TCAS system includes an antenna, a transponder as part of the transponder unit, and also a processor that interacts with the aircraft's navigation system to predict the paths of nearby aircraft and provide advisories to pilots to avoid collisions. So let's have a look at the controls associated with the TCAS system and where that's located. Which is down here on the first officer side of the pedestal as part of the transponder unit here. And you see these two white controls here. Both of these are the controls for the traffic collision avoidance system. So on the right side, you've got standby TA and a TARA selector. Essentially, when the system is in standby, it's off, and we should get an alert for that up here. Yes, TCAS standby. That's not where we'd have it in flight normally. Part of takeoff checks, usually we would make sure the system is in TARA, which stands for Traffic Advisory and Resolution Advisory mode. So that ensures we get all necessary advisories to avoid a collision. There is a middle selection there of Traffic Advisory, which is essentially muting out resolution advisories, and you may sort of ask, why would we want to do that? The most common situation is that it's used in abnormal situations, which usually on an engine failure, we want to go into traffic advisory mode only, because the aircraft in a resolution advisory mode may tell us to climb the aircraft at a high rate of climb, and on a single engine operation, that's probably not something we want to do from a speed management point of view and could put the aircraft in jeopardy. So we ignore resolution advisories on an engine failure situation, single engine operations. Other than that, generally, as a rule, during normal flight, you want to be with the right selection, which is traffic advisory and resolution advisory, TARA. Over on the left here, the other control, we've got four selections. And basically that controls the data that we see on the navigation display. So as you can see, we've got, let's have a look, we've got some diamonds which depicts other aircraft around us. You get a minus which indicates they're below, and a plus which indicates they're above. Sometimes you'll see a trend arrow which tells us whether they're climbing or descending. And we've also got the altitude as well. So this one is 3,000 feet below. You may see the other number, so you've got 47, so that's 4,700 feet below. So it tells you where the other aircraft are in relation to the aircraft you're flying, which is very useful. So when we're over on the left selection, which stands for threat, on the left side, basically that mutes out all aircraft, hides all aircraft which are not a traffic advisory or resolution advisory threat. So nobody's a threat to our aircraft. It's not just not showing any data. Usually we do not use that mode during flight. We want a bit of a forward-looking view of the traffic around us. So we would display more data than that normally. So the next selection, can't quite see in the sun there, is all. And what all shows us is all traffic that's either down to 2,700 feet beneath us or up to 2,700 feet above us. Now, it's not a bad place to have it, and depending on how much traffic's around you. So it's a balance of how much screen clutter you have, how much, you know, important information we need to display on there. And if you're in somewhere with very dense airspace, busy traffic zones, something to keep an eye on. You don't want to clutter your screen up too many targets, but you want to see the relevant ones or your state of flight. And the other two selections over on the right, so we've got an above and below selection. Above we'd select for departure and use that all the way up to our cruise level. So it gives us a deeper look of the airspace above us, up to 9,900 feet. Because the aircraft is quickly moving upwards, we want a forward-looking view of the airspace that is above our aircraft. It gives us an early warning, if you like, of traffic targets ahead of us. You can see here, one is at 9,600 feet, descending. There, so it picks that aircraft up. If we were to then do the opposite and move that switch to below, see that aircraft has disappeared, but we've got a whole range of other targets that are beneath us, some of them, you know, 5,200 feet, 5,000 feet there beneath us. So it's giving us a deeper view of traffic below us, which is useful in descent. And also we would select that if we're having a rapid decompression situation from cruise and we had to descend the aircraft very quickly. One of the checklist items would be to ensure your TCAS system is in below mode, so we've got that deeper view, forward-looking view, an early warning of traffic that is beneath our aircraft, so we can avoid those targets. So there are the two selections. Essentially, the left control is controlling the data we see here. As long as your system is in TARA mode, regardless of which switch selection you have on the left, you will always get your traffic alert and resolution advisory, or traffic advisory and resolution advisory. Yeah, that's just basically a filter on the left control in terms of what data you see on your navigation display. So they're the controls. Now it's important to know the aircraft type and what sort of system you've got. So this is the CEO variant of the A320. There is a TCAS autopilot option which allows the aircraft to use the autopilot to fly a TCAS resolution advisory. So if an aircraft was to come too close to us, we may be told to maintain vertical speed. We may get a climb instruction or a descend instruction. And our vertical speed tape here on the right of the primary flight display will display red and green colours. Essentially, you want to fly the green, so you want to get this needle into the green zone. So you'll see if we had to climb, it may be red up to the first 1,000 feet, but then green somewhere around 2,000 feet, and that's the target vertical speed we need to achieve. So we want to get the needle into the green. The new Neo variants of the Airbus have TCAS autopilots equipped with their standard configuration, so they all have that. The CEO variants do not usually have that, although there is an option on the Fenix to turn it on, so do double check what you've got. So this being a CEO, I have not turned that option on as to be true to life, if you like. So we would manually fly a TCAS a resolution advisory. So we may be flying along, for example, and we may get a TCAS climb instruction, wanting us to climb at a rate of about 1500 feet a minute. So the actions for that would be the pilot flying would announce TCAS, I have control, and that informs the flight deck that we've acknowledged that threat and someone is taking action. The next step would be to take the autopilot out, and then what we want to do next is ensure that both flight directors are turned off. Now there's a bit of a gotcha on the flight directors. It's important to turn those off to ensure that we get the aircraft into the correct speed mode. Now I'll show you that now. So if I incorrectly, so a scenario could be that we are descending. So if I put in a descent to 2,000 feet below, so flight level 80, and we went thrust idle open descent. Now, if suddenly we had a TCAS, so this could be a situation where, you know, we're going to be start going down reasonably quickly in a thrust idle situation, we may get that resolution advisory. We may want, then we'll get a TCAS alert saying traffic climb, and in which case we would say TCAS, I have control. We'd take the autopilot out, but in this case we forgot to take the flight directors off, so we're putting back, we're looking for around about 1500 feet a minute climb rate. somewhere about there we want, but you can see that the aircraft remains in thrust idle. Not a situation we want. It shows you the danger there. I'm going to nose back down. Just reboot our speed back up. Get the autopilot back in. So yeah, there's a bit of a danger there on not taking the flight directors out. It's really important. And the opposite will happen. So the opposite would happen in a descent situation. So we could be climbing out of on a London airspace, for example, and all of a sudden we get a traffic and resolution advisory saying descend. If we've got to take the flight directors out, we're going to keep high thrust on, and it's going to be difficult to descend the aircraft properly. So it is important to take out both flight directors in that situation, and that will what that would do is force speed mode. So we did the same thing again now. It's just so we had a climb instruction. I put the aircraft into a descent first. So I'll set it up how we had it before. So we say TCAS, I have control. Autopilot comes out. Both flight directors come out, and you can see level the wings and climb. We got into a speed mode, which is a much safer place. The aircraft is adding thrust, allowing us to climb, which is what we want. That's the importance of using the taking the flight directors out in a TCAS situation if it is a manual TCAS aircraft. So do check your variant. As you'll need to know how to respond and respawn quickly. Do remember that a TCAS, so a resolution advisory, overrides air traffic control instruction. Usually the pilot not flying who's handling the radios will inform ATC by saying TCAS climb, the call sign, and or TCAS descent. So immediately that controller knows that you're responding to an RA, you're either climbing or descending, and they can coordinate to other traffic. So that's a brief look at the traffic collision avoidance system. They are becoming more advanced all the time. Some of the new aircraft you see coming out, see the aircraft call signs on there as well. So it's really, really useful for situation awareness. You can hear air traffic control talking to the aircraft. You can then see the aircraft turning. You know the instruction it's being given, so you can see ahead really what risk that aircraft is posing to you. So great for situational awareness, and a really good tool for us when flying the Airbus. Any questions on that, please drop them in chat. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I look forward to seeing you on a live stream again in the near future, or indeed look out for another tutorial. Thanks for watching.